Continue where we left off this morning.
We'll see how long we play. It might be another short stream.
But at least it's stream.
Just saying.
So, what I was missing this morning was the crest. I was scrolling too fast. When you scroll across, like, see how this doesn't have any yellow in the center? This one does, and it means you're supposed to look at it. So, the crest was in the room with the expensive things on the desk. History. Well, I would have thought I would have been in history.
That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need.
Thank you.
That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need.
Well, fuck off then. It was none of those. None of those. None of those. None of those. Another no bridges goes encyclopedias. Marks.
and symbols.
Ah!
Coat of arms of the Marsh family. That you could scroll over.
A lord who hangs around in a public house. Let's pay a visit to Lord Marsh. We'll pretend that we're interested in his charitable activities.
Sleuthing.
Mr. Holmes, you have a visitor.
Oh, just ask him to wait.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. This young lady refuses to wait for anything.
What?
Father!
Caitlin!
Miss Caitlin's boarding school was flooded. Everyone was sent home.
As if it could smell any mustier.
My word, how is it possible that you have grown up so fast?
You'll be staying. Wherever will we put you?
Holmes, I'll give her my room, of course.
What do you have to say, Caitlin?
You're on a new case. A respectable lady who's being blackmailed? Or is it a love
story
between a prince and a suffragist?
However did you guess?
You will tell me, won't you, Father?
We'll see. If you behave.
All right, then. Have fun. I'll go and unpack. Will you help me, Mrs. Hudson?
Yeah, no, she looks creepy. Not a fan. I haven't been to the rest of the house. Meh. Is he gonna let me do anything? Nah. Let's go here. Practical mother wrote in paragraphs. She just keeps looking at you like, this is fucking stupid.
About Caitlin. Yes? She has grown up, hasn't she? Don't you think it's time to tell her?
To tell her what, Watson?
Well, about her father.
Never. Absolutely never. Do you hear me?
Holmes, you were responsible for the death of her father. You owe her the truth. She is old enough now.
I would lose her. Can't you see that? She must never know. Watson, is that clear? It won't and can't happen.
Good day, gentlemen. Welcome to my home. How may I help you?
Good day to you, Lord Marsh. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
Okay, let's get a close-up of this sick bastard.
Thank you.
crap.
I hope we're not disturbing you. You are with your physician?
Yes, this is Dr. Reuben Fisher. But no, please, I'm intrigued by your visit, Mr. Holmes.
I'm glad to hear it. The last thing I'd wish is to upset the patient. Lord Marsh, can I just say that I admire all of your efforts in assisting the poor of London?
Yes. It is a war that we must fight on our streets and now, too, from my home. You must surely have noticed those bags full of items, clothing and books for the unfortunate.
That is inspirational. At my own level, I too try my best to support those in need. I thought perhaps that I could be of some assistance.
I don't see why not. I already have the valuable assistance of Dr. Fisher, who happens to be my personal physician.
Forgive me, Lord Marsh. You're looking very pale. Might I offer Dr. Watson's assistance?
That is kind of you, but I feel confident that I can provide Lord Marsh with the care that he requires.
How long have you been like this, my lord?
I'm fine, Dr. Watson. Don't fuss. It's only influenza. I'll be better in a few days. I can feel it already.
It's curious. Your face seems familiar to me, Doctor. Oddly, I'm associating it with Whitechapel.
Well done. You are right. I do occasionally frequent a few hostelries over there, would you believe it? Not that I am a drinker. But there, dressed as a working man, I can approach the other fellows to see if they might be interested in a special job.
A special job? May I ask what you're referring to?
Certainly. Since Lord Marsh began his special education program in 1889, he foresaw that such people would need an occupation of some kind. And so, with or without education, we propose these opportunities to work with Lord Marsh. It offers the less fortunate a chance to help make London a better place.
That's remarkable.
Yes, indeed. In order to truly see, one requires vision, yes, but also insight. And Lord Marsh has believed this since he was a child.
Oh, Dr. Fisher makes it all sound so romantic. Let's close this topic.
Okay.
Gratified by your interest in my charity, you're the first who has offered to help. Despite my title, yes, I have to share my home with these bags full of food for the poor. I'm gratified by your interest in my charity. You're the first who has offered to help.
I'm intrigued by the special education. Last year, three orphans were thanks to Lord Marsh and the special education program, a great many poor people had a second chance at life. Lord Marsh, hunting with his friends.
Ah, my dear comrades, Lord Collins and Lord Harrington. If it wasn't for this godforsaken English malady, I'd be with those rapscallions right now.
All in due time, my lord.
Missing.
I've never heard of this man. John Strobridge. I've seen this name before. It was on a missing persons poster.
Don't embarrass me, Mr. Holmes. Indeed, these people have become like a family to me.
That would be a very large family, I imagine.
Yes, the list would be longer than any of your short stories. As for how large, well, Fisher is the one who keeps record.
Might we take a glance at the list?
I regret that is impossible. It is confidential. I stand firm upon that point, Mr. Holmes.
I quite understand. We'll most certainly send a donation towards your educational program. I shall take my leave then. I thank you both and I wish you all the very best.
Likewise, Mr. Holmes.
Click that. I clicked a different thing. This. We hadn't done one of those yet. Oh, I accidentally hit a button and got something fun.
Seen so many provisions for the poor. Certainly not in a lord's house.
I'm intrigued by the special education program. Is there something else that interests you? Lord Marsh believes that he can help all these poor people.
Okay.
Extremely honest.
Okay. Okay, so we need to go to the Widow Trowbridge house. She lives on Dorset, I believe. Yeah, 5. And Dorset is over here somewhere. Oh yeah, this way. This was her sass, yeah. Bunch of creep ass people. Already been in there. That's 4. And that automatically goes to 14. So that's 3. To be 5, isn't it? That's 7.
It's
information, 5 Dorset Street. Okay, don't then. This is fine. Maybe I'm missing something, but I'm like 1000% certain that this here should be that there. Unless... everybody's door. That dude's crazy. This one. Maybe. There's a way.
Never changes. Dirt and beggars everywhere.
Not the way around. Still on Dorset.
Dorset Street.
It's one of these five. Apparently not. It's 10.
Leave the post on the doorstep.
I don't have your post, ma'am.